We are back on Inside Politics. Our guest today is Nashville Democratic Congressman Jim Cooper. Congressman, one of the last acts that Speaker John Boehner did was appoint a House Select Committee to investigate the Planned Parenthood controversy. Two of your Tennessee Republican colleagues are on that committee. Marsha Blackburn is going to be the chair, and Diane Black is also on the committee. Does the Planned Parenthood controversy, in your mind, merit this kind of congressional scrutiny?
Well, I think Americans want the facts and whatever controversial issue is out there, and that's certainly been a controversial issue. You know, we had something like, what, 8 or 9 committees investigating Benghazi. So it's probably appropriate that that Planned Parenthood get its attention.
Well, since you brought up that other select committee, are you concerned this Planned Parenthood committee may become the same kind of political boondoggle that a lot of people charge the Benghazi committees have been?
Well, the latest Benghazi committee certainly seems to have wasted a lot of money and found almost no new information other than the fact about Hillary Clinton's server. And that's interesting, but it really wasn't directly relevant to Benghazi. So often these things start out as hunting expeditions, and they take it as far as politics will allow.
Now, one of the focuses on Benghazi committee was Secretary of State Hillary Clinton. She's now apparently the odds-on favorite to be the Democratic nominee. You're one of the members that's heading up the statewide committee for her within Tennessee. She's coming here soon to campaign. But when she was First Lady, you two had some disagreements, particularly about what kind of health care we have. This is long before the health care reforms we've had recently. So your support for her, is that sort of forgive and forget and move on?
Well, I think Hillary Clinton is a fantastic candidate for president. You know, we saw her perform so well, not only in the Benghazi hearing last week, but also in the debate performance. She's a super prepared and capable lady who would make an awesome president of the United States.
She seems to be poised to win the Tennessee Democratic primary and our primary selection day here for Tennessee, mm-hmm. but her husband won this state in both 92 and 96, but does she really have any kind of chance at all of carrying Tennessee? It's such a Republican state now.
Well, I think she does. She's a remarkable candidate. She used to be First Lady of our neighboring state of Arkansas. She understands the South much better than some other candidates.
She has a much more liberal perception about her than her husband did.
Well, there's perception, then there's reality, but she's lived and loved the South for a long time, and that's very good to see in a presidential candidate.
Even though she was senator from New York and lived a good bit of her life in Chicago.
Well, everybody has a diverse background, and you know, as president, you have to represent the whole country, but she spent more time in the South than any candidate we've had in a long, long time.
So if she's the nominee, who does she run against? What Republican gets through? Do you think it's going to be Donald Trump, Ben Carson? Jeb Bush has been in the race, thought to be a frontrunner, but he seems to be struggling.
Well, this is very interesting. I know a lot of scared Republicans right now who are deeply worried their party's going to nominate somebody who's completely unelectable, and a lot of them are talking to me about Hillary right now, because in her they see somebody who's proven and competent and has generally been a centrist. The Clinton administration is fondly remembered right now as a centrist sort of time when the American economy was really, really strong and a lot of good things happened.
Now, Democrats in this state have not won a statewide election since, I believe, 2006.
Been a while
right.
now.
And Phil Bredesen was the last one. He was elected governor. They have super huge majorities in the legislature. They hold 2 of the 11 seats in our combined House and Senate delegation. How's that ever going to get turned around? I mean, we don't have any statewide races besides the presidential race here next year, but the Democrats, the future does not look good in Tennessee for Democrats right now.
Well, Pat, you're an expert. You know that politics goes in cycles, and it's always darkest before dawn. You know, if we had a good candidate like Phil Bredesen, I think he could win the governorship. You know, it's the key is to find good candidates and run good campaigns. So we've had a dry spell, but we're going to recover from that. And what's important is the competitive two-party system, because voters want a choice. And remember, this is the state of Andrew Jackson and folks like that. So it's our tradition is strong.
What about you running? You've run for state office once before when you tried to run for the U.S. Senate. Some people think you'd be a good candidate for the next time there's an opening in the governor's chair or, for that matter, in the Senate.
Well, you're very kind. I love the job I've got right now. Being congressman from the Nashville area is awesome. I get to represent Davidson, Cheatham, and Dixon counties, and these are wonderful people. I feel about like the luckiest guy in America because most of my colleagues are envious of what we've got here in Middle Tennessee.
Now, you're trying to join on a bipartisan basis to increase voting for 2016, particularly among young people. So far, the millennials are kind of hard to motivate to get out to the polls, although perhaps they'll vote more for president.
Mm-hmm. You know, Republican State Senator Steve Dickerson and I found this very interesting Tennessee law that's been on the books for years, decades, in fact. It says that local election commissions are supposed to go to every high school, public and private, in the county, and get seniors registered to vote. That's kind of an in-place civics lesson. But this really hasn't been happening on a systematic basis for many, many years. So we think we should revive the implementation of that law and get our young people registered. In the latest mayor's race here in Nashville, only 2% of the votes cast were from young people, folks 18 to 25. And I'm not against seniors, but every generation should have their appropriate voice. And this is such a great way to help our young people learn about the democratic process, small d democratic process, and get involved in elections and campaigns.
Another local rule of thumb in politics here is that congressmen don't get involved in local zoning issues, but you're involved in favor of a bill that would limit and probably stop the development of a rock quarry near Old Hickory Dam. I would have thought the Corps would already have rules that would prohibit something like that from happening.
Well, I'm involved in that issue because there is a priceless federal asset there called Old Hickory Dam, and this new rock quarry would come within.
Can't the Corps stop it on its own? Does it need
local
law?
Well, they could, but sometimes the Corps is slow, and we don't need them to get involved and complain about it once there's already a disaster there. We need to prevent any disaster in our area. We know what flooding was like in 2010. We've already had two of the most dangerous dams in America located above Nashville. We don't need to endanger Old Hickory Dam. And I'm all for rock quarries, and there are plenty of places you can put a good rock quarry, but right next to a federal dam that's already half century old and not really designed to be there forever, you don't want to risk a crack in that dam, because if there were to be a crack, the water level of Old Hickory Lake is 60 feet above Nashville, and it wouldn't take long for that water to come downstream and hurt a lot of good people.
Congressman, thank you for being on the show. We appreciate having you here, and I'm sure we'll have you back because it never stops in Washington.
Thank you, Pat.
And thank you for joining us this week on Inside Politics. Hope you'll be back here again for a future show. If you can't get up politics in the meantime, go to the News Channel 5 website. You'll find my Capitol View commentary there. There's a new commentary posted every Friday afternoon. Enjoy the rest of your weekend, and we'll see you back here next time. Goodbye.